वेरी गुड आफ्टर रनिंग फॉर अ फ्यू नेशनल प्रोफेशनल लेवल एग्जाम में और मुझे मिलता है टेक्निकल कैंपस तो वी हैव सीन यू हैव स्टार्टेड द प्री स्टैटिक्स इट मींस दैट वी आर स्टडीइंग द मैकेनिक्स ऑफ फ्लूइड इन स्टैटिक्स मींस एट रेस्ट द फ्लूइड एट रेस्ट वी आर स्टडीइंग. So in that we will study the way we have seen this in previous class, what is the variation of pressure with depth and liquid and the measurement of pressure. The second part we will see now today. So this law of hydrostatic or concept of pressure we have seen, that is pressure at varies with the depth only, and it depends on the intensity of pressure. You can see here this. We have seen the concept, and you see this dou p by dou x and dou p by dou z, they are zero. So it means that the pressure varies with depth only, under two direction it is not varying. This is the concept of pressure we have seen in the previous class. So that's why you can write down that dp by dy, that is varying the pressure, varying with the depth. Dp is the change in pressure, and dy is the change in depth, is nothing but proportional to the density of fluid, that is gamma. We are dealing with economy. The expression shows that the pressure increases in the downward direction and varies directly with the wet density gamma of the fluid. This is law of hydrostatic we have seen in previous class. Okay, in previous class we have also seen the this pressure varies with the depth and is increasing as we go downward, and also we have seen the pressure head, that is y is nothing but p upon rho upon gamma, where rho is the where gamma is the rho into g, where g is the gravitational acceleration, and rho of water generally we are taking 1000, and gravitational acceleration is 9. All these things we have seen, and also the unit conversions, 1 bar is equal to 10^5 pascal, and 1 pascal is equal to 1 newton per meter square. And then we have seen the Pascal law. It shows that the pressure at any point in all direction is same. So we have seen this proof also, that Px is equal to Py, Px is equal to Py is equal to Ps. And this is nothing but the Pascal law we have seen in the previous class. Also, we have seen the pressure measurement with respect to the atmospheric pressure, absolute pressure, that is pressure measured at any point in the universe. It is nothing but atmospheric pressure, and absolute pressure and atmospheric pressure. We are considering the datum, and the difference between the pressure measured and pressure atmosphere is nothing but it is called as pressure god, and pressure absolute is measured from the absolute zero pressure, where P is equal to zero. Hence, absolute pressure is always positive. So this we have seen in the previous class, and also this relationship there, this absolute pressure is nothing but atmospheric pressure minus vacuum pressure. If it is negative, the vacuum pressure is there. If positive gauge is there, the pressure absolute is greater than the atmospheric pressure. If this written as P absolute is equal to the atmospheric pressure, the gauge pressure. Okay, the gauge pressure is nothing but the difference between the absolute pressure and atmospheric air pressure. If you write down, so it will be Pj will be P abs minus P atmospheric, it will come out. The atmospheric pressure at sea level is nothing but 10.13 Newton per centimeter square in the SI unit, or 10.3 meter of water head, or 76 centimeter of mercury. Okay, so this we have seen in the previous class. Today we will see the capillary effect. What is the capillary effect? Due to the surface tension force, capillary effect is generally is nothing but the rise of all liquid surface inside a capillary tube. So if you take a small tube having a very little diameter, then that is called as so if you take that small tube, you can see here it is a small tube, very less diameter, very thickness. If you immerse into the water, then there is some rise in the water level above the water into the container. If you see this water level, this difference, the difference is h, because fluid is due to the gravitational force w, it will be go down, but due to the pressure at what happened due to the surface tension, this the rise of pressure h we are noticing if it is in case of water. Okay, so rise or fall of liquid surface inside a capillary tube due to surface tension, it is nothing but termed as capillary effect, and it depends on the density of the liquid and the gravitational force. That's why it is depend on the rho g or gamma, you can say. So upward pressure due to surface tension is it is the this sigma cos theta c pi into d. Pi d is euro, the diameter perimeter of the surface, and rho cos theta c is nothing but the tangent due to the surface tension. So this is nothing but the upward force due to the surface tension, and weight of the liquid in the column is nothing but he supposes the head. So this is rho g pi d square by 4 is the area, into h is the height, and rho g is this is nothing but w, that is the weight of the liquid in the column, you can see. And another pressure from all around this capillary tube is balance each other. It is around the whole surface, it is balanced each other, that's why it is neglected, not considered. So if you write down the equation, those two forces we find, that is sigma cos theta c pi d is equal to rho g pi d square by 4h. If you h will keep at one side, then this will, due to the surface tension, this 4 sigma cos theta c upon rho g d. It depends on the, you can see rho is the density of the liquid, and this is the surface tension of the liquid. Whichever is larger, it will take. If the surface tension force is larger, the edge, the rise of the fluid will take place. If the surface tension of, if the density of fluid is larger, then the fall of the liquid you can observe into the okay. So then we see here the pressure generally measured in terms of head, because you seeing that you are in concept of pressure, in that you seeing that pressure changes with respect to head. someone is, if there is disturbance, continuous sound is there. Please, if someone is unmuted, mute yourself. Okay. So this is nothing but you can see that pressure changes with the depth. Okay. So we will see here some examples of different pressure measuring devices. We'll see that before that we are taking the concept of capillary tube. So this rise or fall of the capillary in tube is depend on the two factors. Which one? First one is the surface tension of that liquid with the surface of the tube, and another one the weight of the liquid in the column. So this is the enlarged view. This is the enlarged view. You can see here. This is the enlarged view. Okay. So here that's the equation. The equation H is equal to 4 sigma cos theta c divided by rho. So if you see that the rise or fall is depend on the surface tension force and weight of the liquid column. Okay, and that is the rise or fall of the liquid is termed as the capillary. Okay, then we measure the atmospheric pressure with the mercury barometer, and that is also the barometer is nothing but is used to measure the atmospheric pressure, and it works on the same concept of the capillary effect. Okay. And we have creating a vacuum where pressure is zero. Pressure as barometer inside the tube is zero because we are creating a vacuum. We are creating a vacuum, and this is your nothing but your mercury in the tube. Okay. So from this barometer, this difference between this height, this gives us this H gives us. The atmospheric pressure, and we know that the H is equal to P upon gamma, hai na? Because we know that P is equal to gamma H. So if you have to measure the H or head is equal to pressure at a point divided by gamma or gamma, you can say that gamma M, that is unit weight of mercury, because your material is mercury. Okay, so you can measure the head by at any point at the or the atmospheric pressure at any point. So this is about the capillary angle. Now the pressure measuring devices, or pressure measurement, you can say pressure can be measured in the pipe or in the any conduit. How to measure a pressure? The pressure can be measured with the manometers or the mechanical gauges there are two types of manometers. The simple manometer, in that also there are piezometric manometer, there is U-tube manometer and single column manometer. It may be vertical single column manometer, it may be the inclined single column manometer. So these are the types of simple manometer, and which is measure only the pressure head. So they are measuring, what they are measuring? The pressure head they are measuring. Okay. And if you go for the differential manometer, at this in case of this second type, the differential manometer, in that also U-tube differential manometer in U-shape, inverted U-shape, then inverted U-tube differential manometer. These two types of manometers are there. They are why they are called the differential manometer, because we are measuring the pressure at difference point So I will say this is the point one, and this is point two. The difference of this is nothing but in terms of this pressure difference between this one and two is nothing but this which is due by the pressure difference in the manometer, and that's why they are called as differential manometer. It is not measuring the head. The differential manometer, they are giving us different difference in pressure at two point. That's why they are called as a differential manometer. And mechanical gauges are also used. There are different types of gauges. They are Bowden tube pressure gauge, also platform pressure gauge, gateway pressure gauge, and bellows pressure gauge. So these are the pressure measuring devices, you can say. And we are by the tree plot, by the tree layout or tree chart, we are seeing different types of manometers and mechanical gauges. So in simple manometer, there is isometric isometer, U-tube manometer, simple column manometer, and there are differential manometer, U-tube differential manometer, or inverted U-tube differential manometer. Who is the Asha Ravi? Can you open your camera? Who is this Arshad Ali? Please open your camera. Arshad Ali. Arshad Ali, please open your camera. Okay, so this we have seen. Today we will see. So we will come to the just pressure measurement. Pressure measurement generally, as per the pressure concept, you are seeing that in two direction. If the fluid is at rest, the pressure is varying only as per the depth. Okay, so that's why P is equal to rho gh. Rho g is the wet density and h is the head. So this is the simple example is given. The pressure gauge in the water mains is 15 kN per meter square. This is the pressure gauge or measure pressure. What is the pressure head? So we know that pressure gauge is nothing but the pressure, that's P. So here P is given. So you have to find out the head. What is the pressure head? H you have to find out. So you know that P is equal to rho gh. So H is equal to P upon rho g. And you know rho for water, because it is water. Water, the density of water is 1000 kg per cubic meter. Okay. And this is 50 kilonewton per meter square. And this is acceleration. Our gravitational acceleration is 9.81 meter square per second. So you can easily measure the pressure head. And this is a pressure in which it will become 5.1 meter. So simple examples are there. And I will share with you the notes also. In Google Classroom, we will study that notes, and also the daily and sharing you whatever lecture material available. So you can study regularly so that you can easily understand what going to do. So here we will see that piezometer is the simplest gauge. A small vertical tube is connected to the pipe and its top is left open to atmosphere. So you can see this is our conduit. This was our conduit. This is our conduit, and only a small pipe is attached with this. This is where we you have to measure the pressure, or point A you have to measure the pressure. Okay, so simply the head, the rise of the liquid, the pressure at A is equal to pressure due to the column of liquid at H. Okay, that is. And pressure at B is nothing but height of the column of the liquid. So this is it is the piezometer. It is a simple glass tube used for measuring moderate pressure. One end of the tube is connected to the coil where pressure is to be measured, and other open to the atmosphere. So one end of the tube, this is the one end of the tube which is connected with the conduit. This is the conduit or pipe. Let's say the conduit or pipe where we have to measure the pressure. Where we have to measure the pressure. Just one tube is attached with that pipe or conduit, and whatever the head, whatever the rise of the liquid above this level, it is called as pressure as point A, where at B pressure at point. So head is only measured, and this is the simple piezometer. Okay, so the piezometer measures gauge pressure only, as other end at the free surface where it is open with the atmosphere or subjected to atmospheric pressure. It should be observed strictly that liquid should not overflow the piezometer. So piezometer are not used for measuring small pressure. If small pressure is there, then it will not work, or less pressure is there, it will not work. So for that case, we are going for the inclined load manometer. Piezometer are not used. Also, it is not used measuring high pressure. High pressure is there. So head कितना बहुत ज़्यादा लंबा पाइप हमको लगे, है ना? So to avoid that, so this piezometer are, they are not used for low pressure and very high pressure measurement. For moderate pressure measurement, you can use the piezometer. Okay. So manometers, this is if you consider, this is the different figure. The pipe, different types of pipes are attached. Okay, so if very high pressure is there, only this portion, you can not able to use. The head rise of head is too much high. Okay, if low pressure is there, then the difference it will vary small. That's why the inclined pipe we can use. Okay, it will give you some large difference, or this type of pressure. Okay, so this is nothing but simple manometer. Manometer is a simple device that employ liquid column for measuring pressure difference between two points. The simplest form of manometer is called as piezometer. जैसे कि हम लोगों ने ऊपर देखा, जैसे कि हम लोगों ने we have seen above. Okay, so that is nothing but if you say that P is equal to pressure at any point, if I will take this point, okay, the pressure at point P, that P is equal to pressure is equal to rho gh plus ATL. So this plus or minus depend on the density. Or this density and the atmospheric pressure. Now U-tube manometer. You can see the a manometer with two vertical limbs form a U-shaped measuring tube. It is also called as balancing column manometer, or balancing liquid column. Why? Because at this level here and this here, you see that the pressure at this two level, this horizontal level, the pressure is same at both points. Pressure is uniform. as uniform for this liquid, this yellow color liquid. Okay, so pressure is, that's why it is called as, it is also called as balancing liquid column. It is also called as balancing liquid column. So we are using balancing liquid column, balancing liquid column for you to balancing liquid column for you to manage. Okay, so if you measure a pressure at this point and measure a pressure at this point, they are equal. So if I will write down, if you have to find out the pressure at A, okay, and pressure at this point, so if you write down this for this liquid A, which can be the conduit liquid, this liquid having a density rho, and this manometer liquid having a density rho 1. If you write down the P plus rho GH, PA, this is the pressure at this point A, PA, okay, and H is the head about this liquid, that's why I will write the P plus rho GH is equal to P atmospheric, because this is open, this tube is open to atmosphere, okay, so P atmosphere, or atmospheric pressure, you can measure with the barometer. So P atmosphere, you can see the pressure at this point. So pressure at this point, you write down PA plus OGH, okay? And pressure at this point, if I write down, so PATL plus O1GH1, okay? So write down, if the pressure is above of the, this point, you can write down the plus, okay? So P atmosphere plus rho 1 GH1. G is the gravitational acceleration. It is not changing. It is same for both the liquid. 9.81 meter per second square. Meter per second square. Okay. So rho is the pump. It is not changing. What is changed? The density. G is not changing. Rho will change. Density will change. And also the head will change because the density of the two liquids, they are now same. Okay, so for if you are going for the high pressure liquid, you can measure the pressure like using the liquid manometer. Now you can see the inclined manometer. Why we are going for inclined manometer? If the pressure is pressure you have to measure is very less, or less pressure is there, or minor pressure is there into the conduit, then you have to use the inclined manometer. So this is the inclined manometer. Okay, so this all are clubbed in one figure at here. This is clubbed in one figure, or simple head. Okay. And YouTube manometer, it is not there because it is different. But this is the manometer with inclined pipe. You can see here, this is the manometric liquid. This is the manometric liquid, and this is the liquid in the pipe. Liquid in the pipe or conduit where we are liquid in the pipe where you have to measure the pressure. So you have to measure the pressure. Okay. So this is the pressure, the horizontal line where the pressure is equal at this point also and at this point. Okay. So if you have to measure the pressure at O for vertical two, so this is nothing but PO. I write a PO. But here if I have to measure the pressure at that's P plus rho GH. Rho is nothing but liquid. Okay. So PO is equal to P plus this pressure plus your head is H. Your head is H. So that's why P plus rho GH. is the pressure at this P0, at this level. Again, at incline to, if you measure the P order here, at this point, the P0 is equal to P at most here, and if I will write down this distance, okay, it is something H. So here, this height will be the, this is the H1, so the H1 sine theta. Okay, you go like this, this is your theta, inclination of your inclined barometer, this one is H1, and this is the, you have to find out. So sine theta is nothing but X upon H1. Very opposite upon hypotenuse. X is equal to H1 sine theta. So that's why you are written here P atmosphere and incline plus the vertical height is nothing but H1 sine theta. So G is rho 1 is the manometric liquid density, rho G into H1 is this height, this height is X, so H1 sine theta. So P0 at this point 2, if I write or O, at level O, it is P0, P atmosphere, plus rho GH1. G is the gravitational acceleration, it is same. If you compute the pressure difference, so P minus P atmosphere is equal to rho 1 GH1 sine theta minus rho GH. The minus or plus sign depend on the liquid density which pressure you have to use. So these are the nothing but you can see the changes with the density and the head of liquid. So you can generally what you are measuring here, density you know for the liquid which you are using for manometric liquid and the liquid in your pipe, and H1 is the head. What you are measuring? You are measuring the head. You are measuring the head H1 for the H1 for the your this manometric liquid, and H is for the pipe, the liquid in the pipe. Okay, so from this you can able to find out the head. And you can be able to find out the atmosphere at any point in the pipe. Okay, in the pipe you may say here or here or anywhere, you can find out the pressure at that point by measuring the head at that point. Now we will come to the differential manometer. So differential manometer measures the difference of pressure between two points in a fluid system and cannot measure the actual pressure at any point in the system. So here you can measure actual pressure by using the head. Okay, but in case of differential manometer, this is the simple manometer. Okay, simple manometer. But in case of differential manometer, what you are measuring? You are measuring the differential manometer, measuring the difference of pressure between two points. The difference of pressure between two points you are measuring. At A, what is the pressure? At B, what is the pressure? You are not measuring this. What you are measuring here? You are measuring here difference of pressure at PA minus PB. You are measuring here. The difference of pressure you are measuring here. So here also we will apply. We will apply the balancing liquid column. Apply balancing the concept of balancing liquid column. So here at this surface we will draw the horizontal line. So pressure at this point. And pressure at this point, they are same. They are same. If I write the equation for this, what I will write? PA, pressure A, Okay, rho, it is changing with that. So here this liquid is different. Up to this, the liquid is different, and its height is H3. Height is H3. Okay, so I write down rho 3, this liquid, GH3. Okay, now here this is the manometric liquid. So rho 1, the density of the manometric liquid, rho 1, GH1, H1 is the height of this manometric liquid. At this point, at left side of the U-tube manometer, Similarly, if you come to the right side, at this point, pressure at B, okay, plus this head is H2, this head is H2, so rho 2, because density of this liquid is, it is different, so it is rho 2, density of this liquid is rho 2, and G into H2, so this gives you the pressure difference between the two. So you can write down, because you know the density, you know the G, you know the H, so PA minus PB is equal to rho 2 GH, rho 3 GH3 minus rho 1 GH1. Like that, you can find out the pressure between, pressure difference between A and B. Okay. Here also it depends on the density of the liquid, where is minus one. Now here is if you come here. So if the manometric liquid density is more and the density of fluid knowing the pipes are less, you can go for the upright liquid manometer. Otherwise, if the density of this liquid rho 2 here is less, this is less, rho is less, then you have to go for inverted U-tube manometer. The manometer fluid used in this type of manometer is lighter, is lighter than the working fluid. Which are the working fluid? Working fluid at this pipe and working fluid at this pipe A and B. This is therefore suitable for measurement of small pressure difference in liquids. So this manometer, inverted U-tube manometer, it is useful to find out the difference of the pressure between two points if the pressure, small pressure is there. Okay, so we can use this, and here also you can apply the same theorem, which liquid balancing theorem or concept. Here also you will apply. So if you find out A, I will take P minus is minus rho one GH. So this density of this liquid is rho one, and height is H1. P A minus rho is equal to second conduit P B minus, now this is the liquid in manometer rho 2 density minus this one rho 2 GH2, and here the value rho 2 minus rho 3 GH2. Rho 3 is equal for this liquid, rho 2 is 2 for this liquid, and you can easily measure the pressure difference by the inverted liquid manometer for the small pressure. Okay. Differential manometer, this is a well type liquid manometer. If the well type manometer, one of the limb is replaced by a well of large cross section. So here you can see it is well type manometer where the pressure measurement, difference in pressure measurement you can find out, and the one side you have to make a big cross section, large cross section well. Okay, so that is well tied to the barometer. A is the comparison with the cross section A of the tube. So you know that A is greater than A. The pressure at A minus pressure at B is equal to rho of fluid at A minus rho of the manometric liquid, rho of that, and therefore G into H, the head is the difference between the this difference between the level of this. So PA minus PB is equal to rho of fluid minus rho G into H plus Y. If the level in the drop by Y for a rise of H in the vertical limb, so Y by H is proportional to A upon A. Y by H is proportional to A upon A. So P minus AP minus PB is equal to rho of fluid minus rho GH. Okay? So if I write up Y upon H, 1 plus Y upon H will be H. H, if I taken out, because this H is taken out here, so H is taken out, 1 plus, so you multiply here, Y upon H, Y upon H is nothing but A upon H. That is the concept of measuring the pressure difference in case of well tied to a manometer. So it is related with the barium. That's why this is here. You can put the area value and you can find out the difference of the pressure at a manometer. Now the differential manometer and the micromanometer. Okay, a typical micromanometer to arrange the astronomical figure has a reservoir. So this is the reservoir you can see. Okay, reservoir which can be moved up and down. इसको हम लोग क्या कर सकते हैं? It can be moved up and down. Move कर सकते हैं. This is calibrated between point. By means of micrometer screw. So by means of micrometer screw, the reservoir, this reservoir, you can make up and down. A flexible tube at A and B are connected on the flowing liquid or liquid address. Flowing liquid equation. A flexible tube is connected point A and the reservoir. Another flexible tube is point B is connected, other end of the reservoir. One end is with A, another end is connected with the Allen flexible U-tube. Okay, this is the flexible U-tube result. Another end, but placed on the inclined surface. But this pipe is placed on the fixed inclined surface. A reference mark R is provided on the inclined portion of the tube before application of the pressure. So A or B, it is closed, there is no application of pressure, and here is one mark is there, and that mark is called reference mark R at the inclined tube. Some areas kahin bhi. Then what we have to do before application of pressure, what we will do? Level the reservoir, move so to coincide the level reference mark. तो क्या करते हैं, यहाँ रिफरेंस मास है, तो ये रिजर्वायर को हम लोग अप एंड डाउन मूव करके ये दोनों लेवल को क्या करेंगे, बिफोर एप्लीकेशन ऑफ प्रेशर एक लेवल में कन्वर्ट करेंगे. ओके, तो एक लेवल में आने के बाद व्हेन अ प्रेशर डिफरेंस इज अप्लाइड, उसके बाद क्या करेंगे, प्रेशर डिफरेंस इज अप्लाइड द लिक्विड लेवल विल बी डिस्टर्ब. द प्रेशर लेवल हमारे यहाँ अप्लाई होगा तो लिक्विड लेवल विल बी disturb, है ना, disturb the micrometer when is then adjust to vary the reservoir so as to coincide with the reference level. Again reference level disturb होने के बाद again this micrometer screw will such arrangement, then it will again be of coincide with the reference level of the extent of moment of micrometer screw यानी ये जो मूवमेंट हम लोग ने किया है प्रेशर अप्लाई के बाद, तो दैट गिव्स द प्रेशर डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू पॉइंट्स एन, पहले कहाँ था और बाद में जब पहले हम लोग ने प्रेशर अप्लाई करने के पहले रिफरेंस लेवल हम लोग ने मार किया, दोबारा प्रेशर अप्लाई करने के बाद फिर रिफरेंस लेवल से हम लोग ने मेजर किया, तो आपने कितना मूवमेंट किया अप एंड डाउन, दैट गिव्स यू डिफरेंट ऑफ प्रेशर एट पॉइंट ए एंड बी. Now we will see tomorrow the pressure application of pressure or total pressure or total force acting on the total pressure and center of pressure, and we will see tomorrow, and also the effect of horizontal, vertical or inclined surfaces or surface, summer surfaces due to the pressure. Okay, so we will see tomorrow, inshallah. Thank you for joining today. So we will stop here. If you have any doubt, you can ask with me, or we will do okay. Please join tomorrow earlier. First lecture is there. Thank you.